Jesus said, if someone slaps you, turn and show the other cheek. Is such a teaching relevant today?
See, Jesus might have said that to the 12 people who were around him. That's not a general teaching. To his apostles, people who carry his message, he's telling them, if somebody slaps you one side, show them the other cheek. He's not telling that to the whole world. That man, the way he lived, he is not the kind to show another cheek. He comes into the temple and throws out all the business. So he didn't say, okay, you got one shop here, keep another shop there. Did he say that? Physically, with bare hands, he's destroying their business, isn't it? He is not the kind of man who'll show his other cheek to everybody. He's telling his apostles, if you want to carry my message, you must be like this. No resistance in you. No matter what people do, you don't deviate from your path, you just stick to your path. That's all he's telling you. Because these cultures are very dialectical, everything is said with an example or a kind of, you know, an analogy. He is saying that if somebody slaps you on one cheek, show them the other. Don't deviate. If somebody slaps you on one cheek, if you try to slap him on the other cheek, on his cheek, then you're deviating from your path of peace and love, isn't it? So he's saying, do not deviate from your path. Just stick to your path, no matter what somebody does. All he's telling you is, do not become a reaction in your life. If you want to act in your life, you should not react. If you react, you will get enslaved to somebody else. You will go behind those people. So he's just telling you, do not react. That's his way of saying it. So that's not to be taken literally. His life demonstrates he didn't take it literally, isn't it?
In the all-new series, The Truth About Jesus on Sadhguru Exclusive, find out more about the intriguing birth, life and teachings of this wonderful being. Get a yogic perspective on whether Jesus was really born to a virgin and Sadhguru's insights about the teachings of Jesus.
Is such a thing possible?
It could have been initiated by these three people. If you do not create genetic distance, the old cycles of patterns will take effect whether you like it or you don't like it.
This is the most beautiful story about him, that he was an immensely joyful and loving human being.
So Jesus versus yoga. No, no, he is my party. I don't see him as anything different.